Good morning, students. Welcome to today's lecture. In the last class, we discussed rationalization of irrational numbers, where we have seen that whenever there is a fraction with irrational denominator, we try to make denominator a rational number. Okay. And second, we discuss exponent and powers, formulas and equations. Today we will see some questions on it so that you may solve your NCERT questions. Now, okay, the question is rationalize the denominator. I told you that day also, whenever the denominator of a number is irrational, our duty is to make it rational. You can observe here root 7 is irrational, 2 is rational, but when you subtract root 7 minus 2, totally they will be known as irrational number. Now, to solve it or to make it rational, the only possible number is if you multiply it with root 7 plus 2. That day also I told you that if you multiply with the same number, you won't get a rational number. So, you have to go with root 7 plus 2 in the denominator as well as numerator. Why so? The formula used will be a minus b into a plus b, and we all know it is a square minus b square, like this. Now you will say, what is a? A in our question is root 7 and b is 2. So just follow the formula. Formula says a square. A is root 7, so we will write root 7 whole square as the formula, and we have minus, what is b? 2. So we have 2 square. Above we have root 7 plus 2 into 1, it will remain the same in numerator. Now root 7 square becomes 7 and 2 square becomes 4. So we have root 7 plus 2 upon 7 minus 4, that is 3. So this way we have rationalized the denominator. That's not all. We will have some more questions on this. Now see this one. It is very easy one because here root 3 is alone. I have told you, whenever an irrational number is alone in the denominator, it is the easiest question because here we multiply with the same number, both numerator and denominator, like this. What will happen? Root 3 into root 3 will become 3. It became a rational number. And in the numerator, what will happen? We have studied the formula that root A into root B becomes root AB. So root 40 into root 3 is root 40 into 3. Now, let's check, can be solved further. 40 can be written as 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 times the 40 into 3. If you observe, these two can come out as 1. So 2 upon 3 under root 30 is the answer. Okay, now example, this time we have 3 plus root 2 in the numerator and 4 root 2 in the denominator. Still the issue is this denominator, because it is irrational. Now to make it rational, don't think about this 4 because they are getting multiplied. If there was a positive or negative sign, then there was an issue, but right now they are getting multiplied, so no issue. We can just multiply with root 2 and root 2, both numerator and denominator. So see how this will change the denominator into a rational number. Very easy. Root 2 into root 2 will become 2, like this, into 4, this one. And in the numerator we will have root 2 into 3 plus root 2 into root 2, like this. So when we do root 2 into 3, it becomes 3 root 2, and when we do root 2 into root 2, it becomes 2. Okay, so the final answer is 3 root 2 plus 2 upon 8. First try to solve these questions on your own. You can pause the video and then you can check with my solution. Okay, this example, root 3 plus root 2 upon root 3 minus root 2. Please pause the video here only and try to solve on your own and then check how correct you have done it. Okay, so let's see. The denominator is root 3 minus root 2. Again, a form of a minus b. When we have a form of a minus b, we all know we want a number to be multiplied which is of form a plus b. So we can see a is root 3, b is root 2, So we multiply root 3 plus root 2 in denominator as well as numerator, like this. So in the numerator, if you see, there are same terms getting multiplied, they will become whole square, like this, root 3 plus root 2 whole square. Upon, we have a minus b, a plus b, it will become a square minus b square, because a is root 3 and b is root 2. Now, this is formula of a plus b whole square. So open it like that. We know formula of a plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So a is root 3, root 3 whole square plus 2 into ab, a is root 3, b is root 2 plus b square. B is root 2, so root 2 ka square upon 3, 2. Okay, because root 3 ka square is 3 and root 2 square is 2. Now, solve the numerator. Root 3 square is 3 plus 2 into root 3 into root 2 is 2 root 6. Then root 2 square is plus 2 upon 1. And the final answer is 5 plus 2 root 6. Okay, so this way we have rationalized the denominator. This type of question is not in your book. Just to clear your concept, I brought this question. Okay. Now, let's discuss some questions on exponents and powers also. Suppose a question like this comes in front of you. Just by seeing the number, I don't like this fractional power. So, I must try something to remove this fractional power. For that, I have to see this number. Can this number be written in power form? Let's prime factorize it. When you prime factorize it, you will find that 32 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, that is 5 times. So it can be taken as 2 power 5 whole power 2 upon 5. Now we all know the rule of exponent and powers, that whenever we have a power m whole power n, it can be seen as a power m into n. Yes, so we can write this as 2 power 5 multiplied by 2 upon 5. Okay. Now you can see, when this power get multiplied, 5 and 5 are same, they will cancel each other and finally we will get 2 square and the answer is 4. Okay. Again, I am telling, there are many ways to solve a question in mathematics. So don't be afraid. Just be open to every way, understand, then go with the method which you like the most. Okay. Now, second part, I have taken 3 power 2 by 3 into 3 power 1 by 5. Okay, although this looks absurd, but no issue, you can just understand the formula that we have seen in exponent powers. A power m into a power n, what is this? When base is same, the power gets added. So here also you can see 3 and 3, base are same, power will get added. It becomes 3 power 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. Now you will take LCM of 3 and 5, which is 15. Then you will take 10 plus 3 over here and the answer will become 3 power 13 upon 15. Got it? Now one more example, 11 power 1 by 2 upon 11 power 1 upon 4. This time the formula, this one will be used, which is a power m upon a power n. When bases are same and the number getting divided, then powers will subtract. So here also we will have 11 power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. So let's take LCM of 4 and 2, which is 4, 2 minus 1, final answer is 11 power 1 upon 4. Okay. Now this example is very good to clear your concepts. This is, inside we have 2 square, above that we have a cube root, above that we have power of 1 upon 4. To solve such questions, we will go from inside to outside. Okay, just be careful while going. Inside we have 2 square. We can say this cube root can be written as 2 power 2 whole power 1 by 3, like this. Isn't it correct? we can write this cube root as power 1 by 3. Okay, and in the next step, I can write this 1 by 4 whole power. So you can see I have written the same question in the root form in the fractional power form like this. So 2 power 2 whole power 1 by 3 whole power 1 by 4. Now we all know power of powers get multiplied. So we will have 2 power 2 into power 1 by 3 into 1 by 4. You can see this 2 and 4 can be cancelled. So 2 2's are 4, they are cut. So we will have 1 by 3 into 1 by 2. So we will have answer 2 power 1 by 6. I hope you got it. It's very easy. In questions like this, we go from inside to outside. Again, this example I took from Exemplar NCERT. Okay. Now, fifth part. 256 power 0.16 into 256 power 0.09. Before getting any wrong ideas about the question, just go step by step. First thing you know about exponent power is when base is same and they are getting multiplied, we add the powers. So let's do that thing first. We will have 256 power 0.16 plus 0.09. When you add them, they become 0.25. Now, we have not studied anything about decimal powers, but we know how to convert decimal into fractions. Then why to fear? Let's make it a fraction. It will become 25 upon 100. And when you solve it, it becomes 1 upon 4. So we have final question as 256 power 1 by 4. So this was the trick. Question was given you in this form. If you could found this form, it was very easy for you to solve. Okay. Now, to solve it further, we can prime factorize this 256. And I know when I multiply it to 8 times, I get 256 power 1 by 4. This can be written as 2 power 8 whole power 1 by 4. So power of power gets multiplied. We will get 2 power 8 upon 4. 4 to the 8. So final answer is 2 power 2 is equal to 4 is the answer. Okay. Whenever you want to write anything, just pause the video and write it down. But before writing, first understand it. Thank you for today's lecture. Now you can try the remaining questions in the chapter, because all are easy than these questions explained in the lecture. Okay, thank you.